Hi guys, I am Manuel Corbus and this is Corbus Playthings. So today, November 16th, is the International Day of Flamenco. 10 years ago, on this day, the UNESCO declared flamenco as one of the masterpieces of oral and intangible heritage of humanity, and we in Spain, and especially in my region, Andalusia, we celebrate this with the International Day of Flamenco, and we celebrate events with flamenco involved. So in case you don't know, flamenco is a musical tradition of my land, Andalusia. It is at least 3-4 centuries old, at least, but it is believed that it collects influences from very, very long ago, from different cultures like the Phoenicians, the Tartessians, the Iberians, Greeks, Romans, and also from different ethnic and religious backgrounds like Sephardic Jew, Roma people, the Moors, many, many backgrounds, many, many influences, and it is man old. But it has changed, it has evolved, it has been mixed with even furthermore different backgrounds, and it has survived till now, probably in a different way. And it is now considered a genre or a collection of stage disciplines. So because of this day, and in honor to the 12/8 time signature that is so famous and infamous in many of the flamenco palos. The palos or the cantes are like song styles that they have their own rules. In honor of that, and because 10 wasn't enough, I will give you here my top 12 flamenco or flamenco influenced artists, projects and bands. I will not give you much save their place of origin, because in flamenco it's super important the place of origin, because the palos may change from one area to other, and because many of the flamenco artistic names take the city or the province of origin or the place of origin of the artist. That's important, I will mention that, and I will tell you, I will guide you on what type of music they do, and so you will have an idea of what you may have an interest on or not. Besides that, 12 artists or bands are not much, so I will also add a link or something, I don't know yet, in the description box to a list in which I recommend or I list all of my flamenco and flamenco influenced artists that I love to the moment, because I'm still discovering new artists and old ones. There you can check any of them, even the ones that are not here, because that list will be way longer. And that's all, with no particular order, I will start with my top 12 of flamenco and flamenco influenced artists. So the first one is my favorite flamenco singer ever. No particular order.
No particular order.
And she's María José Hierro. She is an artist from the small little town of Pozo Blanco in the province of Córdoba. She's a Romani singer, and she mixes traditional patterns with electronica and with more modern music. Her voice is the most heartwarming thing that I have ever heard, and her songs, most of them, have a darkness that my gothic soul holds very dear. The second in this list is the flamenco metal Fausto Taranto. They are from the city of Granada, and they basically do that. They mix flamenco palos or cantes with alternative metal, an alternative metal that has a little bit of prog. Also, the voice of the singer in metal is the most broken that I've heard. In flamenco, it's quite typical that the singer has a broken voice to express anguish and sorrow and those dark feelings, you know? And usually in flamenco, metal and rock, the singers have a higher tone in their voices, but he has this broken voice that is very particular, and that makes Fausto Taranto very special. The third one is Rosario La Tremendita. She is an artist from Seville, particularly from the neighborhood or the area of Triana, which is considered the cradle of flamenco. She mixes lots of genres, electronica or not, with his flamenco singing, and she has a voice that is very soft but has lots of layers. Her voice has many layers, and her music is very, very special and very varied too. The fourth artist is Gata Katana, whose real name was Anna. She was a rapper. May she rest in peace and in power, because she died some years ago. She's not longer between us, but she was doing something huge, and she had quite an amazing flow. She had amazing lyrics. She was studying politics at the university, and she was very, very knowledgeable. She was very intelligent. So her lyrics were charged with so much social justice, but still the references were historical, were mythological, were political. She said several times that her special flow comes because she comes from the flamenco scene, and that influences her rapping very much. And you could see that in basses that had flamenco guitars in them, or in the rhythm and patterns that she included in her rapping, or in the inclusion of hand clappings, which is very typical in flamenco. So she was something otherworldly, and now she joined the big ones on the skies. The next ones are Califato 3x4, and I say this is in Spanish, but meaning Caliphate 3/4. This is referring to the time signature, actually. And this is a band from Seville too, and they make a strange mix of Andalusian folklore in all ways, like flamenco music, traditional songs, the Holy Weeks or Passover songs that are played in the marches in Holy Week of Spain, which are some marches where they march Catholic sculptures representing the life and passion of Christ. They take all these along with holy virgins and saints, Moorish figures, things from Al-Andalus. They take all these things that are typical in a region in Andalusia, and they mix it with Andalusian rock, with 90s party music, with electronica, with lots of things, and they make the weirdest fuckery that I've ever heard in my life, but also the most Andalusian things that I've heard and seen in my life. So they are amazing. Weird as fuck, but amazing. Next ones, and now we're halfway in the list, are Derby Motoretas Burrito Cachimba. And they play some kind of Andalusian rock, kind of, that they call Kinkydelia. Kinkydelia comes from kinky, which doesn't mean kinky as in English, but as something, I don't know how to explain it. Someone who is dangerous, who is almost criminal, and they take that culture and they mix it with psychedelic rock, and they have like this very special type of Andalusian rock. Then we have La Banda Morisca, a band between the provinces of Seville and Cádiz, and I am from Cádiz. They play like folk music or Andalusian neo-folk, but they mix all these influences that are in Andalusia and all the Mediterranean coast, but they have the base of music from Al-Andalus. Because many experts believe that the music of Al-Andalus is quite of a basic pillar, I don't know how it is pronounced, to flamenco music. So they mix with flamenco and with Andalusian folk music in general, but always taking that Arabic undertone to all of their music. And they are very special, very heartfelt, and you should definitely listen to them. Then you have Camarón de la Isla. Camarón de la Isla is considered by many people the best flamenco singer ever. He was from my province as well, from the city of San Fernando, also known as La Isla, the island, and that's where his artistic name comes from. He was Roma, and he has one of the most broken voices ever. That makes that all of his music, even the one that seems celebrations, sound bitter, always. Also, his bulerias are a palo of flamenco. His bulerias are flaming hot good. Rosalía's favorite flamenco singer is Camarón. And the next in the list is, of course, Rosalía. Rosalía is a pop artist. She has a lot of influences and she mixes flamenco with other genres, but she doesn't sound like flamenco. What I mean is that her bass isn't flamenco, even if flamenco is an influence. But she's basically a pop artist. She's having quite an international projection right now. She has won several awards. Her first album are all covers from flamenco classics, but with a modern twist, but only guitars and her voice. And the second album is now music mixed with trap music, rap, urban styles, pop music, all that is trendy and fashionable nowadays. And it's a pretty good album, but I don't like her attitude. She's a little bit racist, even though she says she's not. But she makes pretty good music, and I can't avoid or deny that, so she's one of my favorites too. We're reaching the last ones at last. Rocío Márquez is from Huelva, and she's an artist that has received several regional, national, and international awards. She is very well prepared. She studied flamenco. She doesn't only sing it. She has a very special voice, and the thing about her is that she plays like traditional formulas to flamenco with modern twists, but these modern twists don't necessarily mean trendy music or electronica or anything like that. Fuel Fandango are a duo. One is Alejandro Acosta, and he's a music producer, and the other is Nita, flamenco singer from Cordoba. And they make this special mix of electronic music with flamenco, following the path that Xambao actually started with their style that they named or they labeled flamenco chill, because they mixed with chill out music. They took this path but evolved it, and they made something different with their own imprint, but following this base of electronic music and flamenco music all mixed together, you know? And finally we have Boludo's Death. Boludo's Death is a wordplay, actually. They are from Huelva, like Rocío Márquez, and they're an electronic and industrial metal band. They have an Argentinian singer, and in Argentinian Spanish there's a word, boludo, which means like silly, stupid. In Spanish, the number 2 is said dos, D-O-S. So Boludo's Death is absolutely a wordplay, and they play this electronic metal music, but in all albums, but especially in the first two albums, they mixed a lot with the music that they used to listen to as teenagers. And this is like electronic 90s electronic party music and like flamenco pop from the 90s that is usually referred as flamenquito, little flamenco, and they make something very special. And that's all, guys. That's my top 12 of flamenco and flamenco influenced artists, bands, projects, what have you, in the world of music. I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that this triggered your interest and your curiosity, and that you check out these artists. I hope that you enjoy any of these artists, whatever you enjoy. If you enjoy electronica, I hope that you enjoy the ones that mix with electronica. If you like traditional sounding music, then the classic ones. If you like metal, the ones that are mixed with metal or with rock music. Whatever you have, anything that you may need to have at least one artist or one band to be suitable for you. So check them out and tell me in the comments down below. And that's all, guys. That's my video for the International Day of Flamenco. Happy International Day of Flamenco. And now, like this video if you like this video, don't dislike if not, that's completely unnecessary and rude. Please subscribe to keep updated, but to keep updated you need to click on the little bell button so YouTube will send you notifications anytime that I upload a new video. If you want to support the channel, please share in your social media so your people will know about these videos. And of course, follow me, my social media will be in the description box down below. We'll see each other in the next video.
Bye.
¡Hasta!
Te conjuro, te dejo prendado. Encima del techo olvido los pecados. Y que todos los santos tienen su pasado.